Thank you. Okay, no problem. Welcome. Yeah, please. Okay, hello everyone. My name is Pablo. I come from Spain and I'm studying game design in Cologne, while I'm also an independent game developer. I'm working more on the animation and modeling part. This is my first time here and my first time I say hello to you all, so I'm a bit shaky, but it's fine. And I have trouble imagining you all naked, so could you just take your clothes off, please? No, no, it was a joke, it was a joke.
Okay.
So, you can see some of the stuff I do here. You can see the software here I use. Mostly Blender, of course, that's why I'm here. But the important is that I only use free software for it, since from the operating system to all the tools I'm using there. You can watch this while I drink a bit of this secret water. Yeah, and I've been lately, well, since 1 year, messing around with Blender Game Engine, and I think it's very powerful. And I'm going to talk about that also. That you can walk. This game is called Hardcore Chicken 3D. If it doesn't look hardcore, it's intentionally, okay? But it's just a prototype. Like, maybe sometime in the future I start developing, I don't know. Just showing some of the rigging. I even rigged the butt, you know, to make it lay eggs. Mostly I learned from Nathan Bechdel with the humane rigging. That was my discovery of rigging somehow. These are for a video game in progress right now. But the engine we are using is Unity, and I would like it to be a Blender game. That's why I'm here now. And this is for a project for university, which was also developed in Unity. Cool. So, first I want to check on you and see how you are feeling with these terms. Like, you know free software, right? All of you, you know what it means, what it stands for, and you're aware that Blender is a free software, right? But how many of you wouldn't use Blender if it wasn't? So how many of you would use Blender if it was for free, but not actually free software? Like, you don't care that it's free software, right? You just, because it's cool. Yeah, that's what I want to change, or at least encourage you to think of it. How many of you use also some of the free software in your workflow? Like Game Creator, all this stuff. Cool, very nice, very nice. You know about free culture too, right? The culture works distributed with permissive licenses. How many of you are using a free culture as a living, or how many of you are doing with this? Awesome, cool, okay, cool. So first I want to apologize a bit because of the superficiality of some terms I'm gonna talk. I will not talk in depth about free software or free culture. I just want to talk about our role as Blender community or our responsibility towards this movement. First, just clearing. Free software means freedom, not gratis. Sometimes I accidentally say libre, and what it means is this, okay? It's freedom in French or Spanish. So the overview of the talk is these three topics. First, I want to talk about my motivations of free culture, then about our role as a Blender community, and then about video games, because that's what I do. Okay, so my motivation for embracing free culture as an artist, as a creator, is because I think it's the only way culture can really thrive and enrich humanity it because it's not only aware of technological progress, but also wants it. The industry right now is making a huge effort to keep an obsolete business model that is impeding culture to thrive by pursuing both creators and users who want to change the rules. This problem, of course, rules in capitalism, which has clashed with new technologies since its beginnings. And in every case, industry has ceded a bit and evolved, changed, but after deadly prosecutions and cultural damage. Ultimately, free culture philosophy is another cogwheel for the change in politics, economy, and social organization. But change don't come by themselves. We have to make them happen. So let's shape our global culture with values that prioritize a long-term happy humanity over a short-term individual benefit, or everything will explode. So what's up with that in the Blended community? What can we do? So as we know, the Blended Foundation, the Blended Institute, is very known for making these open projects, right? And we can find the educational DVDs released under Creative Commons and other free culture licenses. So why isn't that really on our side, on the user's side? Why not all of the users care about it, about Blender being Libre? These users might think it's a matter of ethics, philosophy, that has nothing to do with using the software. So I just use it because it's cool, but I don't care. They don't realize, they don't see the value added to it in contrast with proprietary software. So the fact that this fact and the efforts that Blender Foundation and Blender Institute are making with open source projects shouldn't be ignored. We should be listening to them and seeing it as a viable way of earning your living. We need to stop being mere users and become activists. We have to be activists in the Blender community because Blender is making a huge effort and is itself an activist way of changing the industry or changing the world. The Blender community should be an army of activists who spread the philosophy behind free software. Let's change the phrase that I hear sometime. Blender is cool for a free program to Blender is cool and free software. It's a value not present in proprietary software, as I said. So I would recommend to anyone involved in this community to learn about this. Richard Stallman, Lawrence Lessig, Creative Commons, Copyleft, Remix Culture, Anti-Copyright, Public Domain, Socialism, because this is what Blender is about. If this is just too much for you, you don't want to save the world, where you can start from? Well, I don't know, I just give some advices or the feelings I have. So in your next project, experiment to use only free software. Maybe give it a try to Linux. It's not as hard as Apple or Microsoft. I mean it. It is not hard, okay? Really, I encourage you to do that, just to try and experiment if you believe in these values. And also distribute your work under a free culture license and try to find a sustainable way to do it. So I know how, I didn't tell that. I used Adobe and proprietary software since I'm 13 years old, okay? That's 13 years already. I know how hard it is to break Adobe's heart. But we have to free ourselves from the user lock-on they employ on us. They are not respecting us as humans, they just want our money, or in cases that the service is free, or for free, we are the product. And so all these terms that I don't want to get in depth, but I'm sure you probably know that already. So as the Free Software Foundation says, if the users don't control the program, it's the program who controls the users. So this means you're going to be poor? No, I don't want that. We don't have to be poor with this. Maybe it requires some sacrifice, but at the end, if you find new ways of financing your work that are compatible with free culture, you'll be much happier. We have crowdfunding, we have Patreon, we have Flutter, public funding, unique value. Sorry, I have to. Unique value means if you are selling a physical object with that it's unique, it doesn't exist anywhere else in the world, it has a value. A digital copy costs Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. Wow, a millionaire, awesome. No, this is morally wrong. We have to change that. Personalized value means, as Tom was encouraging us all before, that we teach people, we are doing a personalized service to someone. That's as value. As for donations, because asking works. If you want to sell something and you put a barrier with a price, you're enforcing people to pay. If you just say, look, I want to do this for you, and if you want, you can give me something, it works. You can check Amanda Palmer TED Talk about this. It's amazing. So at the end, follow Blender's Foundation way of financing as a role model, because we are part of it. Be aware of your space-time and embrace the possibilities of technology. There is no middle ground here, I think. Either you are supporting the status quo by not caring, or you're fighting against it, or you're fighting to change it, I mean. Engage your community and raise awareness about this. If you're an educator, don't just teach the software. Teach its reasons to be, its values behind. Yeah. FS is free software, whatever. So after some sacrifice, you will demonstrate that a new cultural industry is possible, despite of the efforts of capitalism to drain it. I'm also in this way. As I said, I dropped prototype software 3 years ago, and I moved my workflow and tried to Linux, and I'm just using free software. And I'm finishing my studies, which means it will get the moment in which I confront financing for myself. And I have to be ready. I'm just studying that to maybe in 2 years or 3 years I come here back and say, I did it, hopefully. So what about video games in this? What do they have to do here? Why do they matter to us as Blender activists? Well, interactive entertainment is the new media, and it's one of the biggest cultural industries. Independent game developers are changing it right now, so it is our chance to engage them and help them shape the new rising industry according to these values. Blender is already present in game development as a professional modeling and animation tool, but Blender Game Engine, even though it's just one click away, it's not that present. I think now is the moment to make it shine and to make developers think that they can do stuff with it. Also, games are software, and as such, they belong open, libre, evolving. And games, just look at video game modding. We've been modding games since ever, and everyone is cool with that. It's been enriching games. And modding means changing a copyrighted work. And everyone now is saying, no, copyrighted works, you cannot modify them, whatever, unless you are in a free world. So I don't have any solution, I just have some naive ideas, okay? Let's start a reaction chain. Let's make cool games that bring professional game developers that make cooler games that bring commenters to improve the engine, so more game developers do even cooler games that bring feedback to improve the engine. Sorry, if you want to. So we make this, as Tom said, the better products we have out there that really show how powerful Blender is, the better these tools will become. This already happened with animation. I want this to happen with games. Another idea, for example, the next Blender Foundation's open project should be a video game. By the time Joe Frankie was out, the video game industry was still looking down the indie developers. But now they are indie developers and mainstream, like, it's everything in the same plane. You go to Steam or with any game store and you see both industry games and indie games. And this is awesome. We just have to take this chance to shape the industry. For example, let's organize a global Blender game jam. How cool would this be? The ground rules, of course, is the use of Blender game engine and the distribution of the games under libre licenses, just like the rest of game jams do. It will spread its use, bring developers, commenters, and feedback. Okay, wrapping up, Blender is free software, but not all of its users know what that means. We have to be not only involved in its development, but become activists that share Blender Foundation's cause. Blender should fuel free culture works that reshape the cultural industry. Let's create libre works and live out of it. Blender Game Engine hasn't penetrated yet in the video game industry as much as other Blender features, and it's now our chance to change the industry. Let's start our reaction chain. Thank you.
We have time for one single question.
I have one question for you all before. Is, am I being too naive? Am I missing something? Are you with me on this?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, what? Am I naive? Thanks.
Awesome.
Question. We have time. I can show you also some of the stuff from this video if you want to see, or I don't know. This, for example, was inspired by Jakub Steiner. Jakub Steiner is a developer, is one of the artist interface designer of GNOME, and his trailers that he makes with Blender. So I just took his idea. Any interest of this? No? Look, you can discuss me later if you want. Cool.
You should discuss it later, because time is already over. Thank you very much. I will ask next
Thank
speaker.
You. On time.
Yes, exactly. Precisely on time. So is here next speaker? He runs. So is here Dalai Felinto? Dalai, we need you.